payday loans, check cashing, rent-to-own furniture, just a few businesses that purport to offer immediate solutions to tough problems for lower-income people. But the cost can be high, sky-high interest rates and tough terms. Here to tell us who uses these services and how they work, Olena Kobzar. She is social scientist at York University, and we welcome you to TVO.
Hello.
Nice to have you here. Give us an overview of the kind of financial services that people who are on the economic margins turn to that perhaps people who are, shall we say, more middle class might not know about.
Well, in 1996, we had the first payday loan company come to Canada. And since then, there's a massive proliferation of different payday loan companies. And what they basically are, they offer check cashing. Some of them offer furniture, rent to own. Some of them offer loans, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
So you got a service. You've got a willing purchaser or
That's
user.
Right.
What's
That's
the problem?
Right. Well, I think there's multiple, there's many different problems. One is this kind of moral idea that it's wrong to exploit the poor, that it's wrong to charge interest, that it's wrong. We have this kind of moral remnants of, you know, making money on money, going back to like the Aristotelian logic on, you know, making money on money is not productive, it's immoral, et cetera, et cetera. And a lot of people just say, well, you know, if a guy needs $200 and you charge him, you know, 650% a year APR on it, that's just, you know, unconscionable.
That's
a lot
wrong.
Of people have that gut feeling. It's wrong.
And that's what happens here?
Yes, absolutely.
Give me an example.
Well, now if somebody wants, let's say somebody needs $300, they walk into a pay lender and they say, I don't have any money right now. Could you lend me $300? So they go in and they lend them $300 plus, and then 2 weeks later they would have to pay $360 on the loan. So it's quite a high APR, a very high interest rate.
$60 on a $300 loan.
That's right, yes.
But the alternative is the person doesn't get the money because he or she presumably is not a good risk.
Right. Well, that is a very, very powerful argument that was made. When Ontario set to legislate payday lenders, as they have regulation now, payday lenders frame the discussions question as, look, these people need to borrow money. They need to actually somehow, if they don't, they're going to turn to criminal elements, they're going to turn to like loan sharks, mafia, et cetera, et cetera. There was this kind of idea of fear mongering. So there was this sense that you need to provide the service, and if you don't, someone else will step in and do so. And it's a powerful argument. But
not persuasive to you.
It is not persuasive to me. In my research, I found that they actually create the need, they create the market, and a lot of people who do end up taking out a payday loan are stuck there for years and years and years.
Now, back in the day, this may be 20 years out of date, this example I'm going to give, so you help me out here. But back in the day, if you received, let's say, a welfare check from the government of Ontario, you might want to take that, you know, it might take 5 or 6 days, whatever, to clear in your bank, but if you went to a payday loan, they'll cash it for you right away. But what do?
They charge you a cashing fee interest, right?
And is it?
It's quite high, yeah, especially for people on income, right? For them, as we know, right, welfare payment, social assistance is, it's not a high amount, and for them, every dollar really matters. And the check cashing fee itself is a percentage that they really can't afford. But in particular, it's the loans that they take, the payday loans, that I find most problematic.
And why, for example, would somebody who's on social assistance need to go to a payday loan place and say, please cash this for me, and even if it costs me 20% of the cost of the check to do it?
They need to eat.
Yeah.
They need to eat. They need money for rent. They need money for, in one of my interview questions, somebody said they need sandwich fillers. They're tired of eating toast and they just want something to put in between their toast.
Do they not have bank accounts?
They do have bank accounts, but banks don't provide these services.
They won't cash a check?
No, they won't. They will cash a check, but it can take 10 days or a week to hold it in a person.
Even
generally
from the government of Ontario?
Even
it takes
from
10
the
days
government
to clear?
From Ontario, yeah.
They're usually pretty good for the money though, aren't they, the government?
I know. Yeah, huh. And they won't provide them a loan. They won't, even if they cash a check, they won't provide them a loan, you know, for their a pay loan, which is what they do.
Now, you pointed out that once upon a time, this was kind of the Wild West, but there are some regulations in place right now.
Right.
Such as?
Well, in Ontario, for every $100 you borrow, the most the payday lenders can charge you is $21 on 100. But that it's an exorbitant amount, I think. For example, you and I, if we go out and buy something, a vacation on our credit card, we'll pay 18%, right? 19%. Some people pay 21% per year. $21 on every 100 still works out to something like 650% a year, right? These are people that can't, you know, they really need $200. These are not people buying, you know, Cuban vacations or SUVs. So.
Right. They are living meal to meal.
Meal to meal, yeah. Paycheck to paycheck.
And therefore, we should be doing what instead?
Well, when Ontario government set to regulate, the question, they had to look at serious things. They said, well, look, ostensibly there's this need. No, banks aren't providing it. They can't get it from their friends. They can't get it from their family. How do we regulate this? What do we do about this? Quebec banned them outright. They said, look, we think that this is unconscionable. This is amoral. This is the wrong thing to do. So
there's no payday loan business in Quebec?
There's no formal payday lending services. Payday lending companies point out that there's criminal loan sharks, criminal MLMs providing these services, but it's hard to find kind of more than anecdotal evidence on this.
So given a choice between not having this business at all and therefore presumably forcing it underground because there is a need for the service.
That's what the payday lending companies say, that there is a need for the service. And therefore, if you ban this outright or if you make the interest rate too low, like 18% a year, that, you know, there'll be criminal loan sharks and criminal elements will step in and provide the service that we are providing right now.
You don't find that a persuasive argument?
I don't find it a persuasive argument. I just think if you look at what happened in the last 20 years, the rise of the food banks, the rise of instability in wage economy, and I think that you can see that there's not a need, the kind of need that payday lending companies say. I don't find that there is such a need as they pertain.
But what's the evidence of Quebec? Now that they've been banned, is there more organized crime as a result?
Well, it's hard to find, no. Anecdotal evidence and some interviews with police officers in Quebec suggest that no, there's not an outbreak of criminal elements in Quebec.
Did I just hear you say they create their own market in the province of Ontario?
Well, they say that they don't create a market. They say when they've come to Canada, they've come to address a need. Right? Banks don't provide this need, so they've come to provide a service that people need. Mm-hmm. And it is a legitimate argument. In my research, I find that they help and they foster and they create this market. For example, if they know someone's getting a social assistance check in housing complex, they would send out advertisings. Here, come borrow some money from us, right? Mm-hmm. They actually go out and actively recruit people to be their customers. If you go in and you take out a payday loan, they ask for reference letters, they ask for your friends, they ask for referrals, they give you deals. So they help create their own market and perpetuate it as well.
But here's what I don't get. Presumably the government of Ontario could put these folks out of business tomorrow if they wanted to by saying to banks, you must allow people, for example, on social assistance to have a bank account and you must clear their checks right away. We can direct deposit and the money's there right away. Why don't they do that?
Right, and they can do so, but when I was interviewing, and it's broadly not just the check cashing, because that's another aspect of it, mm-hmm. but payday loans, right? They can't quite tell the banks to go out and provide a payday loan. Because there is this very interesting argument. Well, I'll address your question, then I'll tell you about the part that I find fascinating.
Okay.
When I was interviewing someone who's a bureaucrat for the government of Ontario and who helped draft the policy, he said, look, the government of Ontario is not in the business of banning businesses. We regulate them to make sure that, you know, no one's kneecaps are being threatened, right? Mm-hmm. That no harassing phone calls, that people know what they're getting into, right? We can regulate the contract. We can tell people that, look, this is what you're getting into. If you have a problem, here's a hotline you can call. Mm-hmm. But we can't outright ban them. But what I find absolutely fascinating about payday loan companies is that they don't just provide a service, a particular service like check cashing or a payday loan. They actually provide a whole bunch of other variety services for the poor people, like secondary auto insurance. They provide telephone reconnection services. They provide wire transfers, automatic bill payments. So this whole other alternative market for the poor, right?
They can ban businesses, though. They can. They have. They do.
Right.
I mean, somebody tried to set up a plasma selling business in downtown Toronto, right, to sell blood products.
Right.
Government banned it.
Right.
So they can ban them if they want to.
Yes, if they decide that that's an issue. Yeah.
They have chosen in their wisdom not to do it.
Right, because we live in a neoliberal society and you can't tell people how to make money unless it's something like a moral issue, like
body
parts.
Okay, so, but if I'm hearing right, if you were in charge, you would ban these businesses in Ontario?
If I were in charge, yes. I find it very problematic for me, especially doing hearing all these stories that people go through. I find it problematic that I pay my interest rate per year is 18%, but someone who needs $200 to feed themselves or their children needs to pay over 600%. I think, personally, right?
Is this a profitable business?
Extremely profitable business, yeah.
If it's an extremely profitable business, why aren't the big banks offering it?
Well, the argument is, and this is, and you know, this is a persuasive argument from payday loans. So the banks say, they say, well, look, there's no money in the poor people. There's more money in someone who actually deposits, you know, $100,000 and takes out a mortgage with us, et cetera, et cetera. But what payday lenders are able to do, they're smaller, the more faster, the more efficient than the banks. They're able to go after particular segments of populations that the banks can go after, right? Mm. And for the banks, being that they're a traditional financial institution, the argument is, look, we don't know that these people are credit worthy. In fact, they're not in many times, right? They've defaulted on a lot of the loans if they've had, you know, any kind of bank relationship. Well, payday lenders are much faster and efficient in extracting money from the poor than the banks are.
Hmm. This industry is not going anywhere, though, is it?
No, it's not. No.
Have you talked to them?
No. I have talked to a few of them, but for the most part, they stay away from anyone who believes that what they, the services they provide aren't necessary or great.
Can I confirm this? You've tried for your work to be in touch with this industry,
absolutely, yes.
And they don't want to talk to you?
No, they don't want to talk to me.
Why don't they talk to you?
Well, I understand it, right? If you believe that that the industry itself is exploitative, then perhaps you might not want to talk to people that will publish this kind of work.
Do you think it just ought to be more strictly, since they're not going to ban it, should they more strictly regulate it?
Well, here's the problem. The regulation that we have in Ontario and other provinces is absolutely toothless. I mean, they've chosen to regulate several things. One is make sure that whoever's taking out a loan, that they know how much are they going to pay. So they posted this giant, you know, I forget what the font is, I think 21 font, this big sheet of paper saying, for every $100 you borrow, $21 will go towards the interest rate. And you have 2 weeks to pay it back, and we won't come and harass you. So they have all these things ostensibly like knowledge and choice. But I found in my research, a lot of people can't read. A lot of them just, you know, don't, it doesn't address their situation. Just because you tell them it's going to cost them $21 for every $100 they borrow, they're not going to choose not to eat, or they're not going to choose not to pay their rent, right? It's the choice. The regulation doesn't actually quite address the problem, right? And this is the problem with specifically provincial regulation. I wish there was a federal regulation. The federal government kind of devolved the regulation of payday loans from to the provinces, and then the Payday Lending Association, CPLA, were able to frame the kind of questions that get asked, as in how much do you regulate, you know, what kind of educational programs you have to have, et cetera, et cetera.
Gotcha. Yeah. Olena, good of you to come in tonight and help us out with this.
It's nice to be here.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Support Ontario's public television. Donate at tvo.org.